poverty is a part of acceptance in this society, and we take care of that.
We study
that. So, what
does that word?
To conform.
Conform.
And it's a part of being accepted to the society, and it's a pleasure for us. Once we divert from the conformity, there is conflict starts existing. Right. So does conflict come under the category of intelligence that we have started, or does conformity? Because conflict takes away the leisure, right? That is it intelligence, or is conformity the intelligence?
But I am afraid not many of us understand the significance of this question. Let me rephrase it for everybody. The question is, conformity is social pleasure. You conform to what is going on, and there is a kind of pleasure in it. She's asking them that is conflict the way for an intelligent mind? If a stupid mind is always conforming to the trends around him, to the pressures around him, does that necessarily mean that an intelligent mind would always be at odds with everybody else, would always be at conflict with everybody else? Yes, that's the question. Is that what you're asking? On the surface, this appears to be true, and there is evidence that this is true. People who have dared to live intelligently have often found themselves at conflict with the society of their times, with the traditions of their times, with the norms, the movements of their times. At the surface, it appears to be true. But it is not really true. You have done that tutorial on conflict and confusion, haven't you? Right? Conflict and confusion. Yes? It talks of two kinds of conflicts. What are they? What are they?
Outward
and inward, outer and inner conflict. What is conflict, first of all, and how is this related to conformity? What is conflict and how is it related to conformity? I'm starting with an assertion that conformity itself leads to conflict. Conformity leads to the more dangerous kind of conflict, which is inner conflict. Conformity tries to save you from outer conflict, but lands you deeply in inner conflict. Are you ready? Outer conflict is with a person or with an institution. Outer conflict is with a person or with an institution or with a tradition. Whereas inner conflict is with yourself, your own thoughts clashing with each other, right? A part of your own mind coming at odds with another part of your own mind. That is what is inner conflict. Why does one conform? One confirms so that one doesn't lose friends. One confirms so that one acts according to the wishes of parents, of family, of society. That's why one confirms. One confirms to save himself or herself from what kind of conflict? Outer conflict. But we rarely pay attention to that this conformity, which indeed does appear to save us from outer conflict, necessarily lands us into inner conflict. Has that been the experience of at least some of you? Outer conflict avoided, inner conflict started. So, conformity and conflict that way go hand in hand. Go hand in hand. And this is for the man who is yet not an individual, who is living a fake life, the life of personality. Then there is the intelligent man. In his case, the situation reverses. He may find that he is having a lot of outer conflict. He may find that he is having a lot of outer conflict. He is taking his own decisions which his family is not liking. He is writing his answers, his exam sheets in his own light, which his examiners may not be liking. He speaks his mind very clearly, on the spot, fearlessly, and that his friends do not like. So there is a lot of outer conflict in his life. But at the same time, there is no inner conflict. He is not torn between personalities. He doesn't have to wear masks. There is no part of him which is pulling him to this side, and there is no part which is pulling him to that side. So over here, he is living in peace. He is composed. And his life has a certain music about it, a certain harmony. There is a different quality in the way he lives. A particular freedom. Are you getting it? Now the decision is yours. You have to choose whether you want to avoid outer conflict and land into serious inner conflict, or whether you dare to take on a little bit of outer conflict but be integrated from here, be composed here. That decision you have to take as young people who are making decisions daily, day in, day out. That decision you have to make.